Hey guys, this is MATLAB Helper and we're doing a tutorial on time domain analysis of control systems using MATLAB. Time domain analysis can basically be defined as the change in a system's response with reference to time. That is, I'm trying to study the change in my control system's configuration, its specifications, its characteristics with a function of time. Whenever I speak of time domain analysis or a time response, I automatically categorize my time response into two parts. That is, first being my transient and second being my steady state. Now, very simply speaking, transient response can be defined as that part of the time response which is rapidly changing or concurrently changing with time. And once my transient response has subsided and my output has reached a steady value, I term that part of the response as the steady state response, or in other words, I say that my system has achieved equilibrium. Now, whenever I do time domain analysis, I'll first have to describe my system, which I do with the help of a transfer function. So I start off by defining my transfer function object sys, which is set to describe the control system whose analysis I want to do. So here I have my transfer function. Now there are several plots in MATLAB that can help me view my time response. The very commonly and simple one being the step plot. So I simply write step plot in the parentheses, I write my sys, that is my transfer function object. Now as you can see, the output that I've received is a graph between the amplitude and time. The input signal that I've given is the step signal in this case, and the transfer function of that system I have already defined. So whenever I have a step signal and a particular transfer function, this is the kind of output I'll get. Now, every system also has specifications that describe the system. So in order to view that, I use the function step info. Here you can see that I have a lot of specifications. I have my rise time, my settling time, minimum and maximum settling time, maximum overshoot, undershoot, peak time. These are basic characteristics that help me define my signal a little better as to how it's changing and evolving in the time domain. You can view more information on this in the written tutorial. Now, another very commonly kind of time function for time response that is used nowadays is the impulse response. So I use the function or the command impulse plot, and in the parentheses I enclose sys. Here I have my output, with my input being the impulse signal. An impulse signal is a signal which is zero at every value other than t is equal to zero. Again, I have a function, a plot between amplitude and time, which is termed as the impulse response. The impulse response is very commonly used, and it's also a very important response that is observed in control systems. Now, I can also have a linear analysis of my system where I'm explicitly defining the input that I'm giving. So first of all, I define the time range I want. So the first number is the number that I want my time to start, last is the number where I want it to go, and the interval, the middle number, describes the intervals. So as you can see, I obtain a matrix which has all these numbers, which is differentiated by an interval of 0.01. Now I define my next signal, which is basically my input, as a sine function of the time whose range I've already defined above. Now I'll be using the lsim command to view my output with the system object I have already. That is sys, followed by u, which is my input, and t, which is the time interval that I've defined. Here I get the linear simulation results, which are customized and can be changed with change in inputs. So you have this original sine wave and the corresponding response for the system. You can always change the input, change the output. Now, in order to view the specifications for the previous plot, I use the command lsiminfo. Now what the LSIM info, followed by in the parentheses the U, which is my input, and T, which is my time. So here I have again a lot of specifications that describe my system. This is used in stability analysis. Now this is a basic overview of time domain analysis and control systems. If you have any questions or queries, leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to MATLAB Helper, and keep watching us for more such videos. Thank you.